Hi everyone, it's Taff. Welcome back to the Forrest. We've had another plane crash. What's our chances of that? Hey, we are very unlucky. We can consider ourselves extremely unlucky, actually. Two plane crashes in as many journeys. But we've come back to the Forrest. They've just had an update, Alpha 0.05, which adds bows and arrows and all sorts of crazy jazz into it. We've also got this pedometer, which was in prior to the patch, but to me it seems absolutely useless. Let's just make sure there's nothing more we need in the plane. Let's get that axe. And boom, we're back in the forest. Where the hell are we? We'll do our usual thing. And, oh look, mushrooms. Can we eat those mushrooms? Yeah, they're not killing us. Great. Okay, so we can eat mushrooms. Mushrooms have been added. Let's get these cases open. So idea is we want to set up shop again. Survive the night. Get rid of those tennis balls. Anyone for tennis? No, fine. And we can have a look. Oh my goodness. What, are we in some sort of tennis tour or something? Look at that, all these tennis balls. It's ridiculous. Right, so yeah, the idea is we're going to just try and survive again and then maybe go on the attack if we can be quite successful. Let's get our lunch for tonight. Oh, he got one away from me. Let's have that. Lovely. So yeah. I've had a quick play with it, and there's some things you'll notice straight away that the textures. Look at these rocks. Oh, you can pick up rocks as well. These rock textures are beautiful, absolutely beautiful. They've done those really nice. Yeah, sorry, I just heard a weird noise. Let's just try and get all the luggage as quickly as possible, so we can get out of this location and let's get some sticks and leave so we can use that for our fire later on. We want to try and get somewhere probably, well, away from the plane crash definitely, and somewhere where we can have, you know, like protection, like I'm stuck, protection from at least one side, maybe like the sea, or if we can get near a cliff face and we can use that to secure our little compound we're gonna build. Right, let's get a lizard. Oh, damn lizard. Got the lizard, and I accidentally killed that blueberry bush, which I wanted to eat the blueberries, but never mind. I've got all the. Oh, what's that? Oh, a spider. Look, that's new. Can we kill it? No. Okay, not that we'd want to. Right, well, where are we then? Right, so we've got like a plane there. Well, not like that kind of plane, but an open plane. Should we go this way? Let's go this way and see what's about. Let's keep hacking these down because we'll get the leaves, which are great for stoking the fires. What have we got on us? There we go. Let's just make some Molotovs just in case we run into some locals. That's enough. We've got leaves, we've got. Put that armor on. We've got some snacks. Okay, great. We do need to go on. Oh, here we go. He's a dead'un. Let's pick up his body parts, especially his head. Oh, I've damn it! I accidentally picked up some poisonous berries, which was a bit of a shame because that wasn't what I was going for. Mr. Rabbit. Okay, let's get out of here and let's see if we can let's get away from the plane. Keep an eye out for any locals. Oh, got another piece of the plane here. One of the things I'd like to do, once we get ourselves set up in a nice little base, obviously we've got the wreckage here. It'd be nice if we could then go and try and find the rest of the airplane. Because there's the cockpit somewhere, and you can. I picked up a flare. Oh, nice. And you can. Here we go. Okay, he's not choppable. And you can actually get like a flare gun. You can find the cockpit with the pilots and everything. They haven't made it. I've seen it in somebody else's video, so. Oh! That's a village. Let's skirt around the village. You've got a totem there. Oh, what are these plants? Can we eat? Oh, they're first aid plants. Great, we'll have some of them. So we'll skirt around the little village there. We'll go this way until hopefully we can find the sea or a cliff face or something. I don't particularly want to be in the middle of nowhere. Now, here we go. We're coming. Ah, I see a yacht. We've got some first aid plants here, which is perfect. Oh. How about this then? How about this? Got a nice yacht there. Oh, and we got a cave here. Ah, should we? Was this too? Oh, it's gone dark. So it's an alpha, so. God, let's wait till we're set up. We don't want to waste our daylight trying to search in a black cave underwater. What have we got here? Got another dead one of these guys. Missed him. Wow, they're giving us plenty of effigy resources. So we got a dead shark. Ah, this you can now actually. Oh, that's now movable, that dead shark. Right, should we see if we can get on the boat? Oh, we've got another dead one. Wow. What's happening here? Do they have, they've got some sort of problem with the sharks or something. Let's try and get onto this boat. Can we get onto the yacht? Oh yeah, here we go. We're on. So we've got a tape, great. We've got some flares. Oh, big axe. Nice. We've got some skulls for some reason. And some rope. Nice. Okay, so we'll use this as our Alamo should we get in trouble. And maybe we'll set up a little. Oh, there's sharks. Can you see those two? There's four sharks over there. Okay, let's get out of the water. Let's get out of the water. Let's feed them an arm or something. So we've got sharks in the water, clowns to the left of me, sharks to the right. Here I am, stuck in the water, going nowhere. I want to get out of this water. There's sharks over there. Get out of the water, get out of the... Can I fish like that? No, clearly not. We need a spear to fish like that. But we've got fish in the little crevices, so that's quite good, in the rock pools. So, what about setting up a cliff, a face, little house thing there? Sound good? We've got some more bits and pieces here. This little Statue of Liberty thing. I'm loving this new axe. I don't know where that rock came from. I don't think you can carry rocks in luggage. It's, you know, wasting your luggage allocation doing that. Really are. Right. We need to get a base set up. We need to get a fire. And we need to do that really now. So if we do it here, we can use the fact that we've got sharks in the water to our benefit. So they're not going to come through there, are they? Because they're going to get eaten, I would hope. Unless they've got some sort of pact with the... wow, look at all this junk in here. This is fantastic. Loads of tennis balls, rocks, alcohol. It was one hell of a booze cruise, that yacht. Right. This is where we're going to set up our base then. So, let's have a look at the basics. So, set up a shelter, fires, usual things, same from last time. Right, so let's set up a little hunting lodge. And let's put that, rotate that out so we got the back to there. Excellent. Now, what I want to do is we'll probably put a couple of walls here. So, if we look to get, we'll get some of the basic walls. So that's a seagull. Some basic walls to start off with, and we'll put one against there. We get a door, and we'll put a door about will that link in? Yeah, there you go. And then we'll get one more wall, which will go there. So that should block us in. I doubt they'll come in through that because that's too deep, and there's a lot of sharks out there. So let's get let's empty some of our inventory and get those going. Let's get a fire going so we can cook some food. Come on, let's work this. Right, I want to put the fire probably there. I've just used all my resources, so let's go and get some. Let's quickly have a drink and a snack just to give us some energy, and let's go and get some sticks and stones. Oh, Let's leave that. They're not going anywhere, so we'll pick them up a bit later. Let's get some stones and some sticks and some trees. So we can... Wow, where's all the sticks and stones? Come on, sticks. Give me some sticks. Right. Oh, where's that? Why are we not using the big axe? Surely this is going to be far quicker. Keep an eye out for any mutants. Right, where the... There's some stones, here we go. Now we're in business. Nice, can we eat the seagull? No, clearly not, okay. Well, we get feathers. Now we can use the feathers for the arrows, for our bow and arrows. So that's quite good. But considering we can't make a bow and arrow just yet, can we break rocks? I don't think we can we? No, we can't. It's worth a try, you never know. The hell? Okay, a climbing lizard over an imaginary tree, fantastic. That was quite special, you have to admit, that was quite special. Alright, so there's the yacht, so this is our base over here. We'll obviously forget the wall. We probably won't be able to get built tonight. We need to get the shelter built, so we are good to go. Need some more stones, that's fine. I hope we're not going to get too much attention from the guys just yet, because if you can get at least a day without them coming to bother you, you're normally okay. It's gone back to this little axe as default again, which is a bit annoying. Ooh. Come on, there we go. Now where are all the rocks, for heaven's sake? This is a seaside, there should be tons of rocks. Well, I can see there's tons of rocks, but there's one you can pick up. But there doesn't seem to be many we can pick up, which is a bit frustrating. Where did that tree go? Oh, right, they were just twigs, were they? They were just twigs. It wasn't big enough to be considered a proper tree, so that's fine. More of these for the fire. What would be nice if there's a little... Ah, yes, there's a little... Here we go, there's a spear. We can do some fishing. Fantastic. So that's good. So we're right near... Oh, here's the logs. Here they are. Great stuff. And we've got another dead zombie. Not zombie. They're not zombies, are they? They're mutants. But that's good. So we've got a fishing pond there. We've got a spear now, so we can do some fishing in the rock pools as well. We've got tons of trees. We can get ourselves set up. We have got a nice little spot here. God, that sea crashing against the thing sounded like somebody snarling then. That's quite freaky. Right, can we get the fire going? No, more stones we need. If we can get the fire going, we can at least get some food on the go, which would be good. Got some more alcohol here. Is that stone yet? Great, I think I've got enough stones now to... Yeah, this luggage isn't going to go anywhere, so I'm not worried about losing it all straight away. Because we can, with the daylight hours we have, getting wood and resources is the primary goal at the moment. There we go, let's use this axe. Hopefully it'll cut through this in no time. So, some of the things you can build now. Obviously we've got all the traps which we can build to protect ourselves. They've improved the fighting mechanics with the zombies and the parry and that kind of thing. They've also improved the zombies' AI and pathing, which should be good. But also, obviously we've got the addition of sharks, we've got the addition of bows and arrows. Addition of some other animals like the spiders. The birds can now be... I think they could always be killed, but you can now use the feathers for the arrows. What am I missing from there? I am missing one rock. God damn it. One more rock. Come on, sun's going in, and I've got my little axe again. Give me the big chunky axe, for heaven's sake. Give us a rock. That's a seagull. There's a rock over here. Great, so that's enough rocks to get the fire going at least. Let's get these logs up. So yeah, it's going to be resource gathering until the sun goes down, which is not going to be too much longer by the looks of it. We are hungry. Well, we're not hungry, we're low on stamina because we're running everywhere, but... Boom! There we go, we got a fire and our house set for the night, which is great. Right, now let's see if we can get some more logs while the sun is up. And then we can start building our wall, probably first thing in the morning. We might have a save during the evening, see if we can skip it, but no doubt the zombies will come and say hello. Oh, it's giving me that little axe again. Give me the big axe, for heaven's sake. That's one of the things they want to do, is be able to toolbar stuff so we can quickly select which item we want. That'd be ghost. But as I say, this is an early alpha. Much still to be done. They've done a lot of work on the sound effects as well. Unfortunately, the rain sound effects is not as good as the original one, I don't think. It sounds like they've actually made a recording sitting on their... or leaning out their window at home. Because you actually hear the rain... like in a metal in a metal drain not drain pipe but you know like a gutter, so that's a bit disappointing. Okay, the sun's about to go down. It's another dead zombie. Mutant, stop calling them zombies, you muppet. Right. I'm stuck. See, it's lovely and sunny that way, it's dark that way, but it's nice, nice lighting effect, actually, caused by the sun going down. Torch and some pills. Look at these, these rocks are just appearing. Obviously, the sea must be bringing them in, and that must be the theory. So they weren't there a minute ago, but I don't know, I'll take them. And you know what, I might stick an effigy up here, just to let them know I mean business. Where's that log? It's over here. Oh, why did I drop it? Must have accidentally selected the stick instead, which for some reason makes you throw your logs around, so to speak. Right, it's getting late, but we need to collect that last log. We can get one part of the wall done then. It's not going to be much, but... come on, let's just walk a little. Energy's down to half. Stamina's replenishing at the moment. Get these feathers. It's a shame you can't. Well, I don't understand. Well, hopefully they'll implement not killing the seagulls, but eating the seagulls later. Let's stick an effigy up here to let them know we mean business. Should we go for that one? Oh, apparently I need two heads. Now, come on. I've picked so many, killed so many zombies. I must have had. No? Okay, well, damn it. Oh god, this lizard. Thank you. Oh, we got a turtle here, look. Oh, they're not killable. They're endangered, of course, so that would be irresponsible to allow you to kill them. So that's fine, I'm okay with that. Right, it's getting dark. We probably... it's getting dark very quickly. Let's just come back. We'll cook something. And there you go. One bit of the wall's done. We got some money and a rock. Let's fire that up. We've got, what's that? Tennis ball. Can play. Oh, it didn't bounce back off the rock. But let's collect all this stuff. Right, let's get some food a cooking. What do you fancy? Lizard? What do you fancy? Rabbit? Should we go for rabbit tonight? Okay, let's get that rabbit going. Stoke that up. Lovely. Okay, so what we got? We got rope, we got rocks, we got some molotovs, we got plenty more alcohol and cloth for molotovs, we got some... Now, I believe... what's that? A cassette player. Wow. What do we use? Restores energy. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'll go with that. What we've got over here? Batteries, fine. Feathers, meds. We've got torch, axe, flares, aloe vera, marigolds can be used for crafting. Okay, so that's obviously probably some medical stuff. Let's get some armor going. Nice, we got some circuit boards. Now, circuit boards and money combined with, is it alcohol? That's now an explosive. Yeah, there we go. I knew it was something like that. So we've got some bombs now. Right, okay, so we've got three bombs, which would be good. Is that ready? Is that ready to cook? I can't actually see the rabbit on there anymore. Where'd our rabbit go? Okay, let's put another. I put a lizard on there. We'll keep an eye on this one. Maybe that wasn't quite dead, and it got away from us. You definitely see the lizard on here. Which is nice, you can actually see when it gets cooked, because it'll go a darker colour. Energy low, hungry, find something to eat. Yeah, don't worry about it. As soon as this lizard's done, we'll be in Happy'sville. There we go. Yum, 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 yum. Right, let's save for the night, and hopefully no one is going to come. So let's save. Good morning, everyone. We look to have had a pleasant night with no disturbances, which is good. Let's get our big axe out. And what was that? Some money. We'll get that. Some paper money, which I believe you can burn. Keep an eye out for any late or early morning patrols. I'm going to say late night, but it's early morning patrols. These seem to respawn, which is great. Let the sharks play with the tennis ball. Great. Missed. Another tennis ball. Another one, sharks. They'll love that. Sharks love tennis balls. They're just like dogs like that. They're always looking for something to chew. Some more alcohol. Some rocks in there. Great. So once we get this wall up, we should be fairly secure. We'll do some more improvements to try and really protect us. And once we've got what we think is probably the best secure location, then I'm thinking, it's a lovely autumnal scene as the light's going through the trees there. Look at that, a lovely orangey glow. Anyway, let's concentrate on what we're doing. Get more wood. Right, can we pick some of these sticks up? Right, where's that tree? There he is. Boom. Ching, ching, ching. Right, those two... Whoa! God, that made me jump. Okay, now listen to the rain effect. Obviously, they recorded it, but in the background, you can hear it hitting metal. So it sounds like they're leaning out their window at the office, maybe. I'm recording that, but... The previous sound effect was a lot better, so... I'm sure that wasn't the original one. But never mind. We'll overlook that. It's an alpha. Where did those logs roll to? There's one, there's two, and there's the other one. Great. Right, so we get this wall built, and then we may put a wall all the way around it. We'll set some whatchamacallums. Standing fires to light the area up. And also give us some protection, because these mutants seem to be very flammable. Well, we seem to be very flammable. There's obviously the bark in these trees must be highly flammable, because it just seems to burn and burn and burn and burn. So yeah, so let's get this, and this is our doorway done. You're probably thinking, why did you have a doorway? Well, we'll be able to defend the doorway. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Now, where's my big axe again? Can I drop that? No. Get the big axe. Uh-oh, I see a zombie. I see two. Let's Let's come back over here, see if they don't see us. There they are, they're running on the beach. No, they seem to be coming straight for us. It's a seagull, don't worry. Oh, here comes the rain. Where'd they go? Did you see them? Missed. So, as I was saying, yes, you can now build a houseboat, or you can also build... you could always build log cabins, but we've now got the options of doing those kind of things. So, potentially, that is what we could do. Once we've got our... Obviously, we'll get our basic shelter up, so we've got somewhere to stay. Where's my big axe? Out of the way, seagull. Where'd they go? I'm really... I don't know. Well, we've got a log there. Let's cut this tree down. Keep an eye out. Keep an eye out for those mutants. They're probably up the tree, are they? No. We're okay. They do climb trees, in case you are not aware. And that can be a bit of a challenge. Eat. Okay, that was a bad eat. Don't eat the red mushrooms. They are bad. Right, we need to pick that up. We got that log there. Are they rolling? They're not rolling. Rolling. No, they're fine. Right, this should be enough to finish that wall, I believe. And then we should be... If we can defend this place, we should be pretty self-sufficient, because... Food isn't a problem. Rabbits, fish, lizards. We can eat it till the cows come home. As long as we can keep off infection, keep the zombies out. Oh, keep saying zombies. That's one of those birds. I wonder what the hell that was then. Just got it from a really weird angle. Where are they gone? We'll have to finish. We could have finished that. If we'd have hit them with the old firebombs or maybe the explosives, we could have potentially have finished our effigy. But I'm not too worried about that for now. We managed to get through the first night, which is pretty much unheard of for me anyway. I've never been left alone the first night. That was a huge bonus. It's got random legs and that strewn around the place. I do want to. We will go on the offensive, I think, eventually. Where's that log? There's the log. Ooh, that seagull almost brushed our hair. Keep an eye out for them. I'd say, worst comes to worst, we'll swim out. We'll chance the swim to the with the sharks. Right. There we go. So that's all blocked up. I don't think... You can't get around there unless they come down the cliff, maybe. They could come down the cliff, but that would be very unfortunate. And what we can do, I want to do get a couple of these. I'll get them, put them inside actually. And we'll get another one. And we'll pop that there. Great. Need another rock for that one. And then, you know, if they come to attack, we can try and stop them at the doorway, and then when we deflect their parries, they may jump back into the fire and set themselves alight, and we should be okay. So that is our effigy, so don't worry about that. Right. What should we do? We can do a couple of things. We can either start building our more permanent residence, maybe up on the hill, a big old log cabin maybe. Let's just go in the water to wash off any remains of blood or anything we might have on us. Stupid stone. Where have these little stones come from? Where have all the The big stones you actually need gone these days. Ah, hello. What happened to you? May I use your head? Oh, no. You're not chop-upable. God damn it. Didn't we need to get the seagull? Sorry, seagull. I got the rock, so that's what I wanted to get. Now, what we got over... Oh, big anchor here. Look at this. What we got over here, then, eh? Dead shark? Big anchor? What is that? Is that just an island, or is that like a ship hull upside down? Oh, that's, not clippable. Some more alcohol. Some wiggly-wiggly something. Probably just seaweed. I got some more coins. Some more alcohol. More alcohol. Loads of fishies. Oh, I'm sure I thought we picked up a spear. No, okay, we'll go back to the pond. Ah, there's a campsite. We'll go back to the pond and to see if there is a spear so we can actually pick that up and get some fishing done as well. Skim some stones. Because you can't splash. No. Oh, is that a cave? Oh, hello. There's another cave there. So we've got plenty to look at, and we've got effigies around the place as well. Okay. Let's go and have a look at this campsite. See what the thing is. Loads of another flare. If we can get... I know there's a flare gun. Oh, dear. Is that a spear? That's a spear, isn't it? Can we get it? There we go. Not quite what it was what it's for, but that works. Other way, seagull. Right. Let's get his head and his bits and pieces that we need. They've got anything in there? No. What the hell is that? Something? We'll pick it up anyway. Great. Now this is... Now are these the edible ones? Let's have a quick look. Oh, hang on. Where's the... So those ones should be edible. The black berries, the round berries are not. Right, so they should be edible. Yum, yum, yum. Okay, we've got some berries there, lovely. So we know we've got some berries there near the campsite, which is great. We've got the fish pond here. We've got our house over there. Great, okay. Let's just finish our effigy off then. And then we'll start the build on the hill. Should we do that? Oh, we need another head. God damn it. Never have enough heads. There's an effigy on the top of that as well. Oh, is that... Now, this big tree, I've heard mention of this big tree, and people refer to it as the prayer tree. They're the evil berries. I think. So this is apparently a prayer tree, which does attract the... Oh, hello. Are you sleeping? Nope, you're dead. There's a lot of... Loads of dead... So this is the prayer tree, apparently. You can't cut it down. Would you reckon it would annoy them if we built our house right and blocked it off from them? I think we might do that. We'll show them our... we mean business, maybe. What do you reckon? Good idea, bad idea? I know you're all shouting, bad idea, but... Why not, eh? We are getting a bit tired, so we'll just wander back slowly. Oh, we've got loads of rocks up here, which is great. So should we... What I might do is just finish the effigy off, and then we might start building a wall from sea to sea, blocking off that whole area. Okay, lovely. So, what do you reckon? Sea to sea wall? We'll go from the cliff edge to the cliff edge, because that's probably the best way. And we'll do a nice big old defensive wall. We'll find the thinnest point. So if we go from about there, what's going on? What's going on with the wall? Some weird stuff. Okay, they can just walk around there. That's not very good. What's going on? What's going on? These rocks are kind of just not really working for us, are they? Can we... Maybe this bit. Maybe we can just block this bit off. They could technically just walk around there. That's rubbish. Okay, that plan's not going to work, peeps. We're going to have to... What about if we build one up here? Yeah, that might be a bit better. Let's go with... Where's Log Cabin? Log Cabin. Should we stick that up here? Right near the prayer tree? That's going to annoy them. Even seeing the building... plans and the planning permission, that's going to annoy them, isn't it? So that's fine, we'll get that done, and we'll put a wall from here all the way over here to here, and then we'll have a nice little we'll basically take their prayer tree away from them, which will show them that we are not to be trifled with in any way, shape or form. So let's go and get some more wood. That seems to be the story of this game, cutting down trees. This is cutting down tree simulator, pretty much, isn't it? So let's do that. We are pooped, so let's slow down. Probably a wall would be a better thing than doing the log cabin. Can probably be the last stage, to be honest with you. I might build... What about a wood holder, a log holder? That's what we might build. Or should we just take him up there? Maybe just take him up there. Okay, that one's going down. I do like this. Wow. How did the tree get all the way over there? I do like this tree cutting animation. They've done this really nice, as you can see the bits being chipped out. I really like that. It's one of the best tree cutting animation type mechanics I've seen. Very impressed. Right. Let's take these all up here. We need 88 logs. Oh my goodness gracious me. 88 logs for this cabin. Let's just stick them in the cabin then. It's going to be a long while coming. So, 86 to go. We only got 86 logs to go. Wow. This is going to be a fair few hours worth of tree chopping. As you see yourself, there's a bit of glitchiness there. But this is good. Look at the rock textures. Don't they look they look fantastic, don't they? Absolutely fantastic. Oh, you little bugger. Obviously this is being created with Unity 3D. One of the more popular game engines for... Are they the poisonous ones? No, I think they're good. One of the more popular game engines for, especially indie developers, because it's such a good little engine. You can actually buy packages and prefabs and assets, as they call them, which you can then add and manipulate as you see fit. So it's a fantastic tool if you're into getting into indie development. Then have a look at Unity 3D. It's pretty good. You can get a free version of the software. It hasn't got all the fancy bits in it, of course, but it's got all the basics to get you started and get you up to speed and creating your own little games, which are fantastic. I'm a little bit worried, but we haven't seen any more signs of the locals. What's that? That is... I'll take that. Actually, one of the things we should do, rather than... Because that's going to take... ages to build that house. So when it comes to... Please don't die doing this. Oh, okay, we're okay. I'm thinking maybe we should build... No, look, maybe we should build a rabbit. A rabbit cage and a garden. Garden especially. Let's get a garden going. Put a garden there. I don't have anything, so we're going to get some logs for the garden. And also, maybe we can set up a couple of traps. But really, I'm thinking about survival. So I'm thinking about food at the moment. and self-sustainability. God, that was difficult to say. Sustainability. Right, where are these logs? Okay, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We've got plenty of logs here. See, one of the things would really be good if this was multiplayer. I'm sure it'll become multiplayer one day, because hefting all this resource back and forth is so time-consuming. But fortunately, we've seemed to have made a reasonable impression, or they haven't noticed us yet, and they've left us alone, which is quite nice. Okay, we're getting a little bit hungry. Well, we're half hungry. Hungry? Okay, there's our garden. Let's plant. And we seeded our garden. Fantastic. Right, rabbit cage, do you reckon? I've never seen a rabbit cage. Let's pop that. Should we pop that there? So, what do we need for this? Sticks. And maybe some logs. So let's go and get those logs. We'll bring those logs back to the house anyway. Sun is setting, so it's not going to be too long before it gets really dark. Thought I saw a zombie. I think it was just a tree. They're mutants anyway. Stop calling them zombies. I'm going to keep calling... Hello. I know we've tried to cut you before. You're uncuttable, aren't you? I keep calling them zombies, and obviously they are mutants. So you're going to have to forgive me for keep doing that. I can't help myself. Played so many mutant games. Zombie games. Oh, God, I'm getting all the way wrong now. Oh, what? Pick up. We've got another log in there. That's fine. So I want to clear all this back. We'll open up the ponds as well. Yeah, and once... Whoa! Careful. And once we get... once we're really secure in our home, then we might go on the attack. I'm thinking we might go on the attack. Do we need any logs there? No, let's put logs up here then. We need some sticks. Let's light that up. Let's get our big axe out. I don't like that little axe when we got the big axe. Makes me feel so much more secure. I don't know why. Probably doesn't do that much more damage. It's got blood on it, so it makes me feel like it's tough as boots. Right. Let's get some leaves for the fire. Get some sticks. Why can't I pick the sticks up? There we go. Sticks. There's fish in there if you fancy fish tonight. Well, we got plenty of rabbit and lizard anyway, so we'll leave the fish for now. I don't know why it keeps picking up stupid stuff like that. Right, some more sticks here. Okay. I think we've got time to do a bit more tree chopping. At least get the logs down. Even if they roll into the pond, that's fine. We can use them in the morning to have a go and start finishing that. Well, finishing. We'll do a bit more work on the cabin. Would you want to forget that idea? Whoop-a-daisy. Almost deaded. Would you want to give up on that idea and actually build a houseboat? Would the houseboat be better, do you reckon? Would you feel more comfortable with a houseboat? I know we've started the log cabin. There's no reason why we can't complete both if we survive long enough. But I'm thinking maybe the houseboat will be a better option. What do you reckon? Right, hang on. There's one log there. Where's the other log gone? Did it roll into the sea? Seems to be getting loads of stuff floating in on the tide, which is quite nice. Let's finish this off. So that is a rabbit cage, apparently. How do we catch rabbit, then? Is there a rabbit trap? Let's have a look. Is there a rabbit trap? Happy birthday trap. A noose trap. That's probably a rabbit trap, isn't it? Do you reckon? I reckon that's to catch rabbits, maybe. But then, wouldn't they be dead? I don't know. Do you have a little bench? Fancy a little bench near the garden? Yeah. There you go. Little bench. Have a sit on the bench. Okay. Let's get something to eat. E, can I get off the bench, please? I'm stuck. I'm stuck. Stand up! E! Oh, yeah, we're up. Okay, so is it still a little bit glitchy? I don't recommend you sit down because you may never be able to stand up again. With that worn out, stoke that up a bit. And let's have a... let's get another lizard. I quite fancy another lizard tonight. Did we not complete this? There we go. Okay, let's stoke that one up. Stoke that one up. Okay. Maybe rabbits will just come in there and get trapped, maybe. I don't know how it works. Oh, is that lizard doing okay? Still there. There you go. Tasty lizard. Now, what have we grown here? These look like some sort of first aid plants, which is quite good. So we might just keep them there. Where was that extra? Was there not another log? Was that it down there? Has it rolled into the sea, maybe? Oh, no, there it is. So what I might do is plant a second garden. Oh, I keep doing that. It's B, isn't it? Let's get a second garden there. Oh, we need another log. Okay, that's fine. Probably wait till morning. I will get another log there. And yeah, we should be golden. So you can see the tops of the tree and where our other house would be there. But potentially what I was thinking... Houseboat. For some reason, it wants to be underwater. Why does it want to be underwater? It's underwater houseboat. Now, that sounds pretty cool, but do we somehow need to... Oh, joy. So how do you get this to work? Because it's not exactly... Houseboat I've always envisioned as in it'll float, but this doesn't appear to be floating. Maybe there? Maybe you can just do a little... Yeah, let's have a look at that. Needs rope. I don't know. What do you think? Worth it or not worth it? Maybe a little raft? Can we... Well, that... See, that seems to be going in the water as well. Maybe we need to build it there. Maybe not. Anyway, we can all worry about this later. It's getting night time. I don't want to go adventure out at night, so let's... go for another snooze and hopefully we'll have an uninterrupted night and wake up in the morning.